HIMT, Hindustan Institute of Maritime Training.
Part of the class is about why fuel injection timing should be changed while you are reversing an engine. To understand the requirement, you start with this, that a particular engine's one unit is at TDC. Okay, it's a two-stroke engine, so all TDCs are firing TDCs. When the piston is at TDC, what will be the position of the fuel can? You will remember that fuel injection starts little bit before TDC and it will continue after TDC also, because combustion continues after TDC. So if you look at any engine, if injection is going to continue after TDC, the pump should be moving, pump plunger should be moving. So if pump plunger is going to be moving, the roller must be on the flank. The flank which is driving it up. Correct? For example, the roller cannot be on the peak. Because at the peak, what does it mean? The movement itself has stopped. So injection cannot be taking place at that time. So if you try to imagine a unit at TDC with fuel injection taking place, it will be like this. Right? Now let us say engine has come to a stop with the same position, that injection is at TDC, it has come to a stop. Now in the same engine, if you want to turn the engine the other way, right? If you want to turn the engine the other way, this way, and if you, without doing anything, you are just changing the rotation direction alone, then what will happen is, instead of the plunger traveling up, like I am just changing the rotation direction, I have not done anything to the cam position. If I am only changing the rotation direction, then what will happen is, the roller will be coming down at TDC. At TDC, the roller cannot be coming down, because injection has to happen either side of the TDC. Understanding? So this is a wrong position. If I do not change the fuel injection point and I only turn the engine in the other direction, then the full timing will be completely off. So how do I get the correct injection in the astern rotation? For astern rotation, which flank is going to pump the fuel? Which flank of the cam is going to pump the fuel? It is this one. So this flank must come under the roller. So you need to turn this cam till the other flank comes under the roller. So you turn the cam like this. And which way is the engine going to turn now? It's going to turn this is the astern position, it's going to turn this way. Again the fuel will be injected. Injection will take place. Right? So the starting point to understand is injection does not stop at TDC. Injection is on either side of TDC. It will still be going on at either side. And plunger will move up only in the in one flank of the cam, which is the driving flank of the cam. So if you imagine a piston coming to a stop, right? And the same piston has come to a stop at TDC. So TDC position for any two-stroke engine, whether you're turning this way or that way, TDC position means firing should be going on now. So if piston is at TDC, which till now turned clockwise, has come to TDC. I have to turn the cam, and it should again mean, even though it is being turned the other way, it should still be in the firing position. Your doubt was that the piston itself will be coming down.
Yes,
that's what you say.
But you reverse.
Piston after TDC will always come down.
Yes, but in that unit you should have firing taking place because it's downward stroke.
No, it should fire because combustion continues after TDC.
Say you don't.
Just because the piston is coming down, combustion doesn't stop.
Maybe it's not closer to TDC. Maybe it's at the rise of the flank. If it's at the rise of the flank, when you shift the cam, piston is coming down. But then it's now going to raise the flank, which means it is on its firing stroke when the piston is moving down.
No. Piston in this unit, while it was turning in ahead position, in this piston, it was coming up and it stopped. A TD. Right?
Okay.
Same unit, now it is going to turn the other way. What I am telling is, even if it turns the same way, it will piston will come down only, no?
It's in the firing stroke, I believe.
It is still in the firing stroke. So whether it is going to turn in clockwise or anti-clockwise, next movement of the piston is going to be coming down. So coming down is what doesn't mean injection should not take place. Still is coming down also, injection should take place because this is still a firing stroke. So all you have to think of is that is why the easiest way to visualize is imagine the piston at TDC. And at TDC, whether you are turning this way or that way, combustion must take place. Combustion must take place. So if you don't turn the cam, there is no way combustion can take place because the plunger will be coming down. Plunger has to be moving up at TDC. That is the reason you need to turn. So don't confuse the piston going. Piston will always go down after TDC. But the combustion will still take place and the injection must take place.
But still, the piston is going to be in the TDC and even the propeller, the roller is going to be in the upper part of this.
Yeah. It will be here. It has to drive now.
This will be a starting of injection, right?
No, starting is here. See, that is why TDC is a good point to consider because TDC is symmetrical for both sides. So whether I am turning ahead or astern, it should be basically in the same position. Injection should be going on. So it will be almost like the same position of the plank, or the roller should be on the identical position on the other side. Because TDC, whether you are turning ahead or astern, is the middle of the combustion where it is going on. So plunger has to be on the rising plank.
This is because we have the angle difference between the before TDC and after TDC. If it is going to be symmetrical in that way also, then it is not required.
No, the cam cannot be symmetrical about this. I cannot make the fuel cam symmetrical to TDC. That means that then the plunger is not moving. Your question is, because exhaust cam, it is other way around. It is symmetrical. Because in the exhaust cam, what is happening is, you are admitting, you are opening exhaust fan from here to here.
Both the directions will be the same.
And at BDC, it will be like this. At BDC, the exhaust valve is not moving. It is fully open. It is in static position. But combustion at TDC, during combustion, the plunger has to be moving. So it cannot be at the peak. So now the question is, if the requirement is the simple way to see is, roller should be on the rising flank for ascendant. So what are the different ways you can do it? One method is keep two different camps. One camp for ahead running, one camp for astern running, and place them side by side and shift the entire camshaft. This method is common for four-stroke engines because they have other valves also. They've got inlet valves, exhaust valve. So it is, you cannot go around turning the camshaft. So all four-stroke engines, reversible four-stroke engines, it is camshaft reverse. Then in the old MAN engine, which had also had this camshaft shifting. BMW had an exhaust valve because it's uniflow engine. So BMW has got exhaust valve. So if they want to turn the camshaft, they had some problem. In the sense that if you turn the camshaft by this many degrees, if you have a cam similar to this, and if you turn the cam by this many degrees, then the timing of the exhaust valve will get disturbed. So they had a cam design where the degrees to turn will be less. So BMW cam before the roller gauge shifting is something you are seeing from the MC engine onwards. Before that, BMW also the entire camshaft used to turn. But it had that different what you call as apple shape cam, what people normally call that. So that cam turns by a smaller angle. So without disturbing the exhaust valve timing too much, we can do that. We'll call it apple or
negative.
I've heard of the kidney.
Call it kidney also. Apple is for an injury. So if the cam is like this, actually it's a cam with a very large dwell and very small base angle. That is the meaning of it. So when I'm shifting from here to here, the angle will be very small compared to what you do with the Sulzer engine. But still it was giving difficulties because it was disturbing their valve timing, it was disturbing their exhaust valve timing for ahead, astern. So finally they gave up that and started shifting the roller to the rest. So from the NC series onwards, roller is shifted, camshaft is not shifted. Otherwise, BMW also had this camshaft rotation. Sulzer had none of these problems till the RT engine came, because they did not have an exhaust valve, so they can happily turn the entire camshaft. So they had a servo motor for the entire camshaft. The entire camshaft will turn to ahead position or astern position. Once RTA engine came, what was the problem? RTA means uniflow engine once again. Exhaust valves are there. So they did not have the option of turning so many degrees. So in the RTA engine, it is the fuel cam alone which is rotated. Entire camshaft doesn't turn. Fuel cam alone rotates. So instead of a single servo motor, there will be multiple servo motors. To reduce the number of servo motors, two fuel pumps will come one by one, I mean next to each other, so that one servo motor can serve two cams. So a six cylinder engine will have three servo motors. Okay, now with the ME engines, all this ME and RT flex engine, all these difficulties are not there because everything is controlled by electronics. But the logic is still the same. Timing has to be different. Right.